Hi, good morning. Thanks for having me.
So, Judah, how does this work? I know that you're catering mostly, I think that, so automated payrolls is not really new, but what's exciting about what you're doing is you're getting into the blockchain technology, cryptocurrencies, in short, hot item, hot commodity these days. How does this cryptocurrency work in your system?
Sure. So the way Solarium works now is actually we give our payroll software to free to most companies, and they use our fintech solution called SalPay, which is a debit card paired with a MasterCard, to actually pay the employees. And what we're using the cryptocurrency for is about 50% of our clients are BPOs, are multinationals, right? Big business here in the Philippines, and they actually need to remit their money from overseas into the Philippines, into SalPay to pay their employees. And so this is costing them a tremendous amount of time, a tremendous amount of money. And so we've launched a cryptocurrency service to actually make it much, much cheaper and easier for them to bring their money from, let's say, Australia or Singapore or United States directly into the Philippines and directly into our SalPay system.
Mm-hmm. Your use of cryptocurrencies, you're going to have what you call a SalCoin. That is the goal, right? It's not in,
correct.
It's not being used yet. Am I correct?
That's correct. So currently right now we're doing what is called an initial coin offering or a token sale. And that's where we offer the coin to the public before we create it. So the smart contract is already deployed. People can view our token. But at the end of the sale, at the end of this month, is when we'll actually be distributing that to all the people and the participants in the sale.
100 million SAL coins will be in circulation, right?
That's correct. Maximum of 100 million.
Okay.
During the sale process, if we're unable to sell any, we actually destroy some of those tokens.
And one SAL coin is going to be equal to 0.003 Ethereum.
So we've actually now changed the price to fiat because Ethereum price has been exploding and going crazy.
Okay.
So actually one SAL token starting out is worth 40 US cents.
40 US cents. What is the technology you're using? Not Ethereum, what is the
So we use, we use Ethereum as well. So we are an ERC-20 token that sits on top of the Ethereum blockchain.
But why Ethereum? I mean, the most common these days that we hear of is Bitcoin. Why did you opt to go for Ethereum technology, which is actually the preferred cryptocurrency of Russia? I mean, Putin himself, gave his vote of confidence for this cryptocurrency.
Yeah, so Bitcoin and Ethereum are really different. They have some similarities in that they're both deploying the blockchain. But Bitcoin is really very stuck to a kind of first generation technology. Bitcoin is the granddaddy of them all. And so its technology is really can only be used to transfer money. Where Ethereum is actually a platform for smart contracts. And it's a little bit technical, I won't get into it too much, but it just essentially allows you to do a lot more than just store a monetary value. And also Bitcoin has become very, very expensive. So because of the rising cost of it and the rising demand of it, it can actually cost up to 8% to remit into the Philippines using Bitcoin. And a single Bitcoin transaction can cost as much as $20 US just to process the transaction. So the whole idea that it was designed for is to be very cheap and very easy to transfer. It actually has moved way past that use case now. And so the newer technologies like Ethereum are much better for this type of remittance service.
Okay, so let's do a quick comparison, because you're saying that if companies or your clients remit through SalPay, through SalCoins, there would be smaller transaction fees. If I am the company, if I am your client sending money home to the Philippines, how much would the transaction cost be versus the transaction cost if I course it through the regular remittance companies that we have versus Bitcoin?
Sure. So we'll focus specifically on the business use case of some of our clients, right? So we have, let's say, an Australian BPO. They have 100 employees that they need to pay every month here in the Philippines. They're remitting around 2 to 3 million peso. And according to them, this is costing them between 2 to 2.5% in about 3 to 5 days. And after using the SAL token to do this service, we'll be able to reduce it to just a few minutes and cost 1% or less.
Oh, wow, that is pretty impressive there. But you know what they always say? The concern always with cryptocurrencies is that, number one, it takes out the regulators. So you don't have regulators to run to when there's a problem. Number two, when I talk to potential investors or potential buyers of cryptocurrencies, their question is, what is my guarantee that this cryptocurrency, which is not sanctioned by central banks or that has had no regulator will be honored in a future time period? What if one day I have this much of cryptocurrency, but suddenly nobody wants to take it? No, there is no taker for it. There's no regulator to say, hey, you have to honor this currency. What do you say to concerns like that?
So first, I would say that certainly cryptocurrency is definitely being regulated, especially here in the Philippines. I mean, we have one of the best central banks in the region, and so they're very forward-thinking in terms of their regulation, but they're absolutely regulating cryptocurrencies, and you're seeing it all over the world. We're seeing a kind of mass adoption of regulation, which is fine. We're happy to work with regulators. We work with regulators now. In terms of the currency, the token is kind of indestructible in terms of a technology. You will always own it. That it's worth money and value to some people, of course, we are very transparent that we say we cannot guarantee that forever. I don't think there's any monetary, right? There's certainly currencies that have been moved out of circulation because they've lost value. So that is just one of the kind of dynamics of currency in general, is who will value it, what is the utility of it. But absolutely, it's being regulated, and there are plenty of regulators to talk to. We are complying with all regulation as we do this sale.
But when I spoke to the Banco Central governor, he did say that the BSP can only regulate once that Bitcoin or that technology, that cryptocurrency, is converted into peso. It is only at that time Correct. When the cryptocurrency enters the realm of the Banco Central or regulators. But what if I plan to hold a Bitcoin for a long time? What is my guarantee that, or do you recommend that we don't hold these cryptocurrencies for a long time and just, you know, for the time being, just keep on converting?
It really depends on what your particular use case is, right? Somebody could have held Bitcoin 7 years ago and put some away in a hard drive, and they would have woken up today and it's worth millions of dollars, right? What was their guarantee that they would have woken up today and it was worth $1? Or I mean, this is just the part of the dynamics of it. For our particular remittance service, though, we don't actually put any risk on the token itself. We just particularly use it to buy and sell, to actually transmit the money, which is one way to reduce the risk, right? So if you don't want to hold onto these tokens because there is a potentially risk factor in their price fluctuation, we use them for our clients just to remit over to the Philippines or to remit over to Australia, and then convert it immediately back to a fiat or a peso currency.
Very exciting. You know, Judah, just this Thank week, you. You've got the futures trading exchange already working in Chicago for cryptocurrencies. Yeah. Really a sign that it will most likely become mainstream, this cryptocurrencies. How about for your company, Solarium? I know that you're handling big companies, 500, 600 companies, 15,000 employees, and you're planning to expand, right? Aside from the
That's
Philippines?
That's correct, yeah. So we've been growing fantastically here. You know, the solution that we provide is a free payroll software for a fintech product. And so it's getting a terrific reception here in the Philippines. And so that's our plan, is next year we're looking to expand to Singapore, Hong Kong, Australia, start to bring this solution around in the region, because a lot of our customers that work here in the Philippines actually work in other countries, and they've been demanding us to kind of migrate over because they really like the product, they really like the service that we offer.
Very exciting times for Solarium. I do have one final question. I know that you have the ICO, which is still ongoing, and next year you're hoping, how many, 100 million coins. You're hoping to have 100 million sell coins. How much of your transactions with your clients do you hope will be done through this cryptocurrency? Do you have a percentage in mind?
So the cryptocurrency will actually become the native currency of SalPay, our fintech product. So actually 100% of the transactions will be settled at some point in the token. But we're hoping that about 50% of our current clients will already use the token to send their money from outside the Philippines inside the Philippines to fund payroll.
Okay. And on that note, thank you very much, Judah, for your insights
you
this
well.
Morning. Exciting times for your company and for the rest of the fintech world. Thanks for joining us.
All right. Thank you as well.